All right, now we should officially be live for our October 2024 Novice Tournament. I am Polly Wally, and I am joined on the microphone by Newsy.
Hey guys, it's Newsy News. I'm really excited to check out our amazing Novice Tournament this month for October 2024. A little known fact, I actually started at the novice level myself. It's such an amazing level. For people who grew up loving Tetris Attack or Panel to Pawn, Pokemon Puzzle League, and want to dip their toes into the tournament scene. But you're going to see today that our competitors are fierce. So let's take a look at our bracket.
Yeah, so we have Dimples, Wirehall Medic, and we have Cordelia with a Knife, who are a couple of our novice players who will be joining us. We're also joined by two other contestants who would typically be outranked, unable to join the novice tournament. They're too high up in the ranks, but they're playing with some alternate means of inputs that make things a little more difficult for them. We got Dog Dog Revolution, or Dog in the Grass, who's playing on a DDR mat, and we've got Recorder, who's going to be playing on a recorder. So that should be very interesting. I hope to see if they can take some wins.
I will definitely be interested to see if they can take wins too. I believe both of them play in different tournaments at different times on these alternate inputs. Very fun for memes. Let's see if they can bring any wins home today.
Absolutely. Well, with no further ado, let's go ahead and jump into, I think there's a match between Recorder and Dimples right now.
Alrighty.
So to start us off, we have we have Cornflakes, also a reporter. I'm gonna probably go back and forth between what I actually refer to him as, but he's got a couple blocks of garbage that he's having a little bit of trouble getting over and getting the clear on. Hopefully, he can get those blues over to make that clear.
So
Meanwhile.
you gotta, keep in mind that for Recorder today, every single move he is breathing heavily through a recorder to make a note, and the computer has to register the note. So it may seem like he's moving a little slow today, but he is moving pretty fast for using his voice, or his air capacity, I guess, on the recorder. Dimples is actually taken 2 wins so far, so we'll see if Recorder can kind of hit a groove here.
Yeah, I'm already impressed. He's hitting slides, which is I wouldn't think that you'd be able to do any little frame tricks or anything like that. But that's got to take some
For
serious timing.
sure. Yeah, for sure.
And so you can see at some of the metrics.
Wow.
Oh, whoa. That was a nice series. It's going to keep Dimples a little occupied with that times five.
Getting a 5-chain on the recorder is pretty amazing, I will say.
I'm just tickled by this. And Dimples makes the clear. Nice job. We'll see if he can send a five chain right back at Recorder. Cornder. Cornflakes.
And so for today, we've got our excellent players that are playing on level 5. It's going to be the best of 5. And since we have 5 players today, there won't be a final round. It'll be the best of these wins. So we will be checking in periodically with our bracket to see how things are going with our final match. Looks like Dimples has taken another win. I imagine Recorder is trying to catch his breath.
And if at any point our audio seems a little off or if we need to make any adjustments, feel free to let us know in the chat. And we're excited to hear
Yes, I
from you
much
either way.
appreciate that. And Polly, when you started tournaments, what level did you play on?
I remember joining the novice tournament and starting out on level 5 as well. Actually, the first tournament I
Nice.
tried to join was an expert tournament. I was like, oh, I'm probably good enough to join the expert. And
Nice.
I'm kind of glad I chickened out last second because it would have gone. It would have been tough.
Well, now you're doing expert tournaments, no problem.
Oh, I haven't done an expert tournament yet. We'll get there.
Yeah, you just have to amass enough advanced wins. Which he has several, by the way, you guys.
Oh, well, thank you. In the meantime, we got Recorder on trying to get it on the board. Hasn't been able to make a win yet, but I'm still, like I said, really impressed. Like, there's another slide. I don't know how he's doing this, but I'm in love with it.
Yeah, it's a little bit limiting at 115 actions per minute, but really doing some very cool things.
Yeah, and if any point you all want to see what kind of the numbers are on the side of the screen, you can see, well, oh, actually, okay, just want to make sure Chrome is okay. But at any point, you can check out things like the actions per minute, which is nice save, Corn. Actions per minute, you've got garbage per minute and all that jazz. We'll talk a little bit more later about that, but Dimples secures the win, 5-0. We will jump over to our other group, our other match that's currently queued up. Wirehall Medic and Dog Dog Revolution. All right, well, Dog is also going for things like inserts on the DDR pad. And they are sitting at a brisk 100 inputs per minute as well.
So here's the real question. You tell me what your opinion is on this, Polly. If you had to play panel attack either on a dance mat or with a recorder, which one would you prefer to do?
I feel like I would rather my legs hurt than my ears hurt.
Yeah, amen. I totally agree.
Wonder how Corn actually sounds at the moment on his recorder, if it sounds like, a musical masterpiece.
The song of death.
Oh, we got, speaking of some death, is, dog.
Tough spot for dog.
He had just sent a big times four chain over at Wirehall Medic, so they are getting some good damage out there. Just trying to secure the win's always the tough part.
It is tough. It is tough. Especially on the dance pad.
All right, that was a good little
Very
setup for my
beautiful.
dog.
Yeah. A lot of forward planning here on Dog's part, even while on the dance pad.
Wirehall Medic doing a good job of defending all that garbage that just came in.
Wirehall Medic is a new player to our Discord, and we are so happy to have them come check us out and participate in their first tournament today. And wow, they are really doing quite well already with 3 wins under their belt, now 4, almost taking the set.
Absolutely. We're always excited to have more people jump in and give these tournaments a shot. It's a little nerve-wracking at first, but the more you do it, the more practice you get. I think the better you do after some time.
Some people say the tournament jitters never go away, but the only way to try is to practice. So, thanks everybody for putting yourself out there.
Dog set up a nice times four to send over to Wirehall Medic, followed up by another little times two chain. Doesn't quite
Yeah.
top off here.
I'm wondering if Dog in the Grass has like a chair or something. You know what I mean? Like, I hope that they post a picture of their setup at the end of this so we can see what it looks like.
Yeah, that's a really good point. If they're like holding onto a bar.
I'm so tired. This is like a real workout. Oops.
I've seen them play a little bit. Like, they're real good at the game. Just the base game on its own. So.
Oh, Dog in the Grass. Yeah, mm-hmm. Dog in the Grass, I think, made it to the brackets on the expert tournament last week. Mm-hmm. So definitely a very talented player.
Well, still
holding. It's a little bit harder on that dance pad, though. Just a little bit harder.
Doing good so far. Making that clear with the greens.
Holding on.
Now we're going to see if Wirehall Medic, who's also not really any tricky now, just clearing all that combo garbage to get a fresh board of some new panels.
Got a nice insert on the dance pad.
Ooh, big attack coming from Wirehall. There's some shot garbage mixed into that one as well. So we'll see if Dog can make the save. Running out of health there. That would have been a little bit of some fast feet. It required some fast feet for a Dog to save with those reds.
Yeah. A little bit of river dance there, maybe. He could have gotten through, but... nice win here for Wirehall Medic.
Mm-hmm. With that, we can jump over to Cordelia's Knife and Dimples.
All right, awesome.
I believe Cordelia's Knife has joined us for some tournaments before in the past, but is also relatively new.
Yes, a relatively newer player to our tournaments. Has been pretty active coming to hang out in BC and getting to know everybody. Seems like a very friendly and awesome player. We're happy to have her as part of our community.
Yeah.
So welcome, and you're already winning two matches, so doing quite a good job.
Absolutely.
For somebody so new, for sure.
And Snickolas, thank you for joining.
Snickolas too. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you either. But I've seen Cordelia's Knife have, you know, matches 3, 4, 5 minutes on 5. So the defense is just unreal from this player.
Whoa. Yeah, I think being able to last 4 or 5 minutes in this format is going to do you really good.
Several people have said, please, it's time. It's time to graduate to 8. So I think this really proves it, Cordelia. Who's playing as Cordelia? Isn't that cool?
You know, I didn't even notice. That's very true.
Cordelia said, I'm the final boss around here, you guys. You better look out. We love to see it.
Yeah.
Girl power.
Ooh.
Oh, yes. Hi, Snickolas.
Yeah. Welcome to the chat. Well, Dimples is saying I'm not going down without a fight, sending a x5 over to Cordelia's.
Nice happy chains. Let's see how she reacts. She has pretty good time. I mean, she's moving quite a bit quicker than her opponent here.
Mm-hmm.
I think it just goes to show that she's seeing more things.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a big part of it is the board vision and just recognizing the patterns and getting just more automatic with all your inputs and all that. Cordelia's doing a good job looking up at that second tier for that clear.
Beautiful horizontal 6. I absolutely love those.
Mm-hmm. Great job holding on and sending a big offense right back. Is doing a good job using that second tier again. It's always good to use all your resources and not forget about that one that's so easy to overlook.
Cordelia is really surviving well under pressure, struggling a little bit to provide the pressure onto Dimples, though. If she can survive and provide a little bit more pressure, then she should be able to take this W pretty easily.
Yeah, and I think a big thing too, one thing I always see in the novice tournament that is folks playing on low stack, not quite giving themselves enough panels. And one thing that I just want to see more and more people do is hit the raise button. Give them some more ammo to get a good offense and take more swings at the opponent and not just play super defensively.
All right, well, novice folks, you heard it here first, and I also feel like this, so maybe I'm slightly personally attacked by Polly, but that's okay. I also struggle with the issue of having a low stack because it feels so safe, right? And it's awesome.
Absolutely. It's like, but you know, if you don't have any panels, you don't have anything to defend with, even though they all
exactly.
are, they're also the thing that killed you.
You need panels to send garbage, you guys. Come on. Nice vision here from Cordelia again.
Shock combo.
Let's see if those shock blocks pay off. I was looking at those too, Polly. Three shock blocks stacked up.
Yeah, that's gross.
That's from a five. Quite a bit there. A little unpleasant. And Dimples, looking
save.
A little scary.
Yeah, but he did it. I was a little worried too.
Got through.
Dimples is using all.
Oh, don't lock out, Dimples.
Yeah,
careful,
that's it.
Dimples. Oh, such a tough spot.
Yeah, it would have actually been better not to make the clear on the shock blocks and carry the red over from the far right left and, try, you know, that was kind of like the last option, so burnt it and...
Sometimes, yeah, when you're defending, it's just so hard not to overburn.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Because you're just like, as long as I'm burning panels, I can't die. As long as something's popping, then all of a sudden you're out of panels. Or like that big chain is just so beautiful. You're like, I have to finish this big chain. And then you look up and it's like, oh crap, I have nothing left.
I'm extremely guilty of that. Like, the number of times where I'm like, did my opponent, like... sit there and listen to me chain that for, you know, do a big old chain and then decide to send me a big attack right at the end of it or before I could hit the raise button, like.
And that's a strat. That's definitely one strat.
A bit of a carbon combo storm coming over on Dimples. Was able to downstack it and make the save.
Dimples is really fighting hard to try to get on the board here, but Cordelia's offense is just, or it's her defense really is oppressive too, but he's got these great counterattacks that make it so tough. Mm-hmm.
Oh no, Dimples. Whew. Got a little scared there, had a little miss swap. Ate into our health a little bit, but we're okay. Is Dimples gonna find a way out? We're still burning, which is always good when you can't find a solution. Just keep burning and eventually find something.
Nice vision on those greens from Dimples.
I agree. Yeah, it's hard to keep track of things when everything's downstacking and falling all at once from combo garbage getting burnt up.
Good downstacking habits now will pay off so much when this competitor gets to the intermediate level.
Worried. Let's see. Okay. Dimple's still good. Just having to fight this awful layering of these shock blocks are just interrupting all the burns and just... Ugh, I'm so... What are we gonna do, Dimples? Nah, couldn't quite make the save there. Good job
from our
These were
nice,
titans.
Long games. Yeah, excellent job, and congrats to Cordelia, who's really coming out looking like a potential winner of today's tournament. Somebody definitely to keep an eye on.
Absolutely. And I mean, and great job to Dimples too. You know, even though you couldn't quite get a win on that one, the score at the end didn't represent how well you played. I think that you really were putting up
snaps,
a great fight.
Snaps for that, for real. Because, you know, you see these sets and you're just like, oh, it's 0-5. But then you actually look at the set and, like, these are, like, 2-3-minute games. Like, these are big fights. Definitely shout out to Dimples today.
Absolutely. So, we've got Wirehall Medic taking the first win off of Recorder. Oh, and I guess Cornflakes had a little issue, need to step out, or maybe they had got interrupted and that's the actual end of their set. We'll have to see about that. Well, while we wait, we might check out our bracket, see how things have updated.
Yeah, let's check out our bracket.
Yeah. So, hit refresh, make sure it's all up to date. So,
what are our power rankings today, Polywally?
So, we've got Wirehall Medic currently in the lead, has 2 wins, no losses. Cordelia with a knife has also is at 1 win, no losses. That may just change in a moment when we update that score. Dimples had just is at 1 win, 1 loss. Dog Revolution at no wins, 1 loss. Recorder is at 2 losses. So we'll see how things mix up as we go.
That is awesome. And it's just great to see some of our newer players coming out with such a bang, a big splash on the scene. And, you know, even our players playing on some non-traditional devices who've come to support the tournament. Just love to see it.
Absolutely.
Oh, here we go.
We got the 2 stars right now. They are Recorder versus DDR Matt. Who will come out on top?
At this point, you gotta think maybe Dog's legs are more tired than Cornflakes' lugs. We're not sure, but
who's to say?
Who's to say?
Well, Cornflakes taking the first win might just be the first indicator.
Wow. Shake out the legs, Dog. It's time for the ultimate showdown.
Oh, did I get kicked out? Okay. Okay, just a little bit of catching up. Sorry about that.
Oh, no worries. We're good. We're still at 1-0. Korn is winning currently.
Right, so Dog raising up the stack a little bit, trying to get a little bit more panels to mount a bigger attack. Cornflakes having a tough time, but finally making the clear on that stack of combo garbage. Sounds like they're both trying to mount a good attack now. Cornflakes with the inserts to save for the save.
Tough spot. Oh.
It's tied up, baby.
tough to, you know, get the lung power to move from all the way down at the bottom of the board all the way up to the top.
Absolutely. So, who's going to take the first strike in this round? Oh! Oh! That, like, triple delay chain from Recorder. That was
very
impressive.
Nice. Cornflakes is also a great player in his own right as well. I believe having won an intermediate tournament before, or sorry, I mean an advanced tournament before.
Oh, nice. Now he's taking on his toughest challenge yet. A dog on a DDR pad.
Dog, that was so cool. He got an insert on that DDR pad too. See, when Dog plays with the regular, I don't know actually if Dog is controller or keys. I'm not 100% sure. I should remember from our controller versus keyboard tournament, but when Dog plays on a normal device, Dog's always getting cool tricks. So it's so cool to see him still getting those cool tricks on a dance pad. That's wild.
Yeah, and for the record, I'm pretty sure they are a controller player. Get that.
A controller player. Okay, cool, cool. Controller players unite.
I'm a keyboard player.
Oh, boo. No, I'm just kidding. We still love you.
Well, it seems like I'm going to have to be a DDR player.
Dog taking our third game. We're almost to a set point here. Mm-hmm. Corn's got a little bit to come back from here.
We have some intimidation tactics as our players line up their first attack. Corn starting with a 9 combo. Ooh, got some interesting combo chains mixed in there.
Ooh, wow.
Dog with a double insert. All that combo garbage came down right on Dog, but they were ready with the clear.
Dog definitely has a lot of panels to work with here. Getting a nasty combo chain. That's going to leave Cornflakes topped out.
And Corn had just
raised
the stack.
Bit of a tough spot.
Yeah. Oh no. No, no. Don't wiggle. I guess the simplest thing Corn could have done was move the purple over 2 spaces above the green and then drop the green off the stack, but that's a lot to coordinate with with a Recorder.
Yes, exactly. That's definitely tough on the lung capacity.
We're at set point.
Corn does have a chance for a comeback, but it's a long road. Dog here just has to win one more match to take the set. I believe both of them are catching their breath right now.
There we go.
Alrighty. The show goes on.
Dog starting with a times 3, Recorder starting with a times 2. Okay, okay. Dog also showing off a little bit of an uncert. Followed by an insert. Oh. Dog really tacked on that chain, just adding to it more and more. 3 to times 5. And that's what's going to do it.
That's the game. Wow. Well played.
Dog able to prove that they've got faster feet than Corn's got faster fingers.
That is one dancing dog with some smooth moves. Have you ever played Dance Dance Revolution, Polly?
Oh, only after a couple drinks. I
totally
it's the only
fair.
Time I'll get on it.
It is a good workout. So I'm sure, hopefully Dog is drinking plenty of water. Corn too. I bet it's also a workout to be playing recorded as long.
Absolutely. So we'll jump over and check out our new updated bracket. Cordelia
okay.
has taken the lead with 2 wins. Wirehall Medic is at 2 wins but 1 loss. Dimples is at 1-1. Dog takes that first win. And Recorder at 3 losses. But I am happy that Korn has been able to get a couple wins. You do see on that fourth column, Korn is sitting with 2 points, so has gotten 2 game wins, and excited to see that he is getting on the board.
Alrighty.
We'll jump in, we got some more games going, so let's check out Wirehall Medic and Dimples.
Alrighty, awesome. Wirehall Medic, somebody who's on the board high up with Cordelia as well. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely contender for taking the entire tournament. I'm just now kind of also getting caught up with the chat. That is something I'm constantly actually trying to work on, is keeping an eye on the chat while things are going. It's nice for you to be joining us, Bellaviquez. Sorry we couldn't have you at the beginning. Hopefully we can get you at a better time next time. Wirehall Medic in a bit of a situation. We got some towers on the left and right doing a little bit of down stacking. Finds a solve with the reds. That was some good vision. Now, is he going to find a clear? He's kind of making a bigger hole to come across, but finds one with the purples.
Love that four vision.
Meanwhile, Dimples is sitting pretty with no garbage to worry about. Besides a couple stray combo pieces here and there. As I say that.
And those fours can really cut up the board. Luckily, Dimples figured out how to manage it and get rid of them quick. But they can really cause problems for players that just, you know, neglect to handle them.
Yeah, if they work their way into your stack and you haven't gotten rid of them, haven't addressed them, then you're going to be in a world of hurt, even though they're just tiny little inconveniences.
Some really nice looking layering on Dimples. I've just been really impressed with Wirehall coming out, you know, for their first tournament and just showing off some of these great skills. Mm-hmm. Definitely showing a strong foundation in their panel upbringing game of choice, which I'm not sure if it was Tetris Attack or Pokemon Puzzle League or Panel Baton. But a lot of people come here and they say, hey, I beat the super hard mode on Tetris Attack or Puzzle League, so this will be a breeze. And then they get here and it's a little bit different than they expected. We've got a lot of very fierce competitors. So, you know, gotta respect somebody who comes out and shows so strong like this.
Yeah. I mean, a 3-minute game, I've been seeing an earlier against Cordelia and the other match that we saw with Wirehall Medic, a multiple 3-minute games. Nothing to sneeze at.
I also want to give a shout out to the bravery of our competitors today in playing ranked matches. Sometimes tournaments can be tough and you can get tournament jitters, but I think playing ranked matches in a tournament, especially for the novice, you might not find somebody else who can rank you in on level 5 outside of the novice tournament. So if you are curious about checking out our community and want to dip your toes in, the novice tournament is the perfect place to start. Try not to get too intimidated by these excellent players we have on the screen right now, but we have a lot of great community tournaments as well. We're trying to put together a Halloween tournament. Chaos has a couple tournaments, and then we have all different levels every week. I'm just going to drop the Discord real quick here as we take a look. Oh, and Dimples just snuck in another win there with that juicy layering.
Night, yeah. Wirehall Medic, I think, accidentally raised up a little bit too much. Was trying to give himself a few more options, but went a little too far. Yeah, so just to reiterate what you're saying, like, if you haven't joined the Discord, please check it out. It's a great way to find out about all these different tournaments. We're always trying to do more and more with the community. Right now we're making our own custom characters for the game, so we're not using any other IPs or anything like that. And so we have folks who are composing music, who are creating art for and ideas for new characters, and if you want to be a part of that, all you got to do is check it out.
And it's free.
Mm-hmm.
So come check us out.
And I do think you made a really good point earlier that, I think that there is a little bit of frustration with some beginners because, a lot of people who stick around kind of get better, and then there's not a lot of folks who are newbies who can play with new people as they come in. So I think this novice tournament, if you're ever a little worried or nervous or say like, I don't think I can join in, like, this may be one of the best chances you have to go against other folks that are at your skill level. So don't be afraid.
It is a competitive environment, but it's also a very friendly and, I don't know, kind of collegiate environment. We're all here to learn, and we're all kind of on this panel journey of learning this game. And so, it's wherever you are is awesome, and we want you. We
Absolutely.
Want you. All right. Wow, Ian.
Firehall Medic
right,
striking
the
back.
Witch here getting on the board.
All right, our two competitors are taking some pokes at each other. No real big chains or anything. As I say that, Dimples is doing it times three, but still waiting to top off each other, see who can make the first big strike. This is one of those moments where I would love to see our contestants raise the stack a little bit. Get a little bit more ammo to easily shoot off some big chains at their opponents. Sometimes it's hard to find and see an opportunity for a big chain or a big attack or something like that. And honestly, the best way to kind of improve that first is to just give yourself a big board of panels, which, like we said, scary. Raising up is and hitting the top is what kills you, but on the other hand, You know, you can't win if your opponent doesn't ever hit the top of their board.
That's totally true. And how cool would it be, folks, to have Polly Wally every time watching your games being like, raise, hurry guys, raise it.
Oh, I don't think anyone
wants
that.
That's what I need. Can you? No, I do.
Ooh,
I need that help.
I think I would get kicked out of this community very quickly. People would be like, shut up.
No, constructive criticism is always good. Always good.
And like I said, I am also very, very cognizant of that too. I am very frequently finding myself getting caught in low stack, and someone sends a big chain at me to punish me, and so I'm just like, well, now I just get to sit here for the next 30 minutes, and all I can do is just chew on this chain, and so it's good across all skill levels.
Yeah, it's interesting, like, no matter how high you get up, some of the problems are still the same, you know? Playing too low stack, playing a little bit too safe, not sending enough chains.
Yeah, these are the universal things you gotta work on. So now we've got a little bit of a competition. Both players are just about stacked off. Wirehall Medic looking for a save. Quite able to make it with
that
those
combo
yellows.
Storm from Dimples, really 12 floors there, really impressive.
Yeah.
Game smart plays.
Yeah, for those not in the know, combo garbage can be really actually much tougher to deal a little tougher to deal with than chains sometimes. You know, you think chains are the big honking pieces of garbage that would give you the most trouble, but those little tiny bits, when they add up, they give you a lot less shake time, and you have much less time to actually to react to them. So it's definitely utilized at the higher level. Folks will focus on doing more chain garbage actually than any more combo garbage than any chains. Firehall Medic doing a little bit of down stacking, trying to burn and find a clear. Makes one with at the very last second. And now we're going to see if he's able to make the save with the blues.
Oh, so close!
One swap away.
One swap away. And Dimples takes the fourth game. Now we're on our set point. That four just at a very inconvenient location for Dimples right now.
Yeah, we were talking about it. It can really dig into your stack and be very frustrating to deal with. Medic making a couple burns, waiting for a moment.
Sorry if you heard that in the background, guys. I was just getting my laptop charger, so we're good now.
No, you're good. It was like newsy ASMR. Click, clack.
It's me rummaging around and stuff. Nice job from Warehall pulling that purple over to make the four. Both kind of poking around, seeing if somebody might slip here just from some combo garbage.
Yeah, these two are definitely focusing on having a good defense. So You know me though. I always just want bigger numbers. I want those big nasty chains, even if it's not the smartest thing to do.
The chains, they call to me. That's how I feel when I sometimes when I play players who have much larger chains.
That kind of reminds me. There's also another little, another one of our members, Chaos, just kind of made a recent little experimental build that favors a player who is a little bit more offensive than defensive, since there's a bit of debate within the community, you know, that the game can be a bit too defensive at the higher level. So if you're interested in that kind of thing, just make sure you check out the Discord, and you can download that for free and give it a shot.
That was super fun. There was a tournament in that day.
Yeah.
We got punished for having good habits, didn't we, Polly?
Oh my god. Well, I don't know if I would say it was if I have too many good habits. There were plenty of times where I was trying to panic down stack and trying to, I don't know. I could have been a little safer and lived a lot more times than I had died.
Hey, you gotta take risks at this stage of the game, right?
Yes, so.
Risk it for the biscuits, just like Wirehall here, fighting to hang on, getting hit by absolutely massive amounts of Garbo right now. Let's see if he can find this clear.
It's getting there. He's burning stuff, but none of it's touching the garbage at the top, so... Oh, wasn't able to find a solve with the purples.
Solid win there from Dimples, and still very well played Warehall. 4 minute match.
Very,
very
nice.
Impressive.
Alright. We...
I think we're good here with our tournament. Let's look at our brackets and announce our winner.
I think actually we do have another one. I think maybe they were waiting.
We do?
Maybe? Am I crazy? Yep, there you go.
Okay, our last match of the tournament. Let's go.
Mm-hmm. Yep, I just happened to see in the Twitch chat that Cordelia said that they were going to wait for the final match.
Cordelia would like to show up on this Twitch stream that I can't even imagine. Cordelia has just been showing up and just taking the novice bracket by storm. Definitely excited to be doing great tournaments. That's hopefully she'll come to chat out on the intermediate and maybe even come hanging out with our jury commentators at some point. Fingers crossed.
Absolutely. Oh man.
Beautiful timing on those range effects from Cordelia.
Alright, and Korn answering right back with a times four with two sets of combo garbage mixed in. Is Korn... Nah, not quite able to find a solve there. That was a monster of an attack. What an opener.
Absolutely amazing. Cordelia just blowing over the air. Korn play taking a deep breath because she is in for a heck of a fight.
Oh, Korn said in the chat, no, my dog started barking and he made my stack raise. All right, man. Excuses. I'm kidding, because I've tried that software to try a recorder thing of my own, and that thing is so sensitive to sound. Everything will set it off. Absolutely anything in the room. Oh, man. This kind of consistent chaining, just like you said, I'd love to see Cordelia's try the intermediate. I think that she could absolutely hold her own in that tournament and make it pretty far.
Yeah, for sure. And it can be tough, you know, for us, you know, with MTO, trying to figure figure out, you know, who's appropriate for what level here. And I say, Cordelia, I'm definitely ready to graduate on that.
Corn, you can make the solve with those reds or the purples.
Corn is holding on, takes deep breath. Playing as two for his life right now. Meanwhile, Cordelia's knife is throwing on another chain. A four chain now. Ooh, such a nasty layering. Corn, yeah. She just couldn't hold on.
Couldn't.
And Cordelia's knife takes another.
Yeah, he tried to go for the bringing the green all the way over, but it may have been saved a couple inputs to try to just bring the red over for a horizontal clear. So maybe it's something you can check out, but
future.
Oh, Corn almost saving. Okay, makes a save. Those reds are gonna fall and make another chain, so that buys him a little bit more time. Downstack and try to get those purples. One downstack. No.
Oh,
not quite able to make it.
Corn working to get on the board here. Again, Cordelia is my dominating performance this tournament.
That's it, baby.
Wow. Holy guacamole, Cordelia's knife with the sweep. Well played.
Very well played. And actually, this is our last one. I just double checked our brackets. Dimples and Dog.
Yay. Okay.
Currently, Dog is so topped out. Trying to get that green over, couldn't quite do it. So we're able to catch them.
Nasty layering.
Right at match point for Dimples.
Match point.
Match point is always so much pressure, right?
Yeah.
Even if you're one that's going to win with the match point, it's still a lot of pressure.
Absolutely. I just want, at that point, I just so often feel like I just want the match to be over. I'm like, please. I just.
Yes.
I can't take the pressure anymore.
One more and I can be done. It's too much. Cool six from Dimples,
yeah.
Wins them the game.
Absolutely. So, now with that, I think things are all wrapped up. So,
all right, let's take a look at our final bracket.
Sure. I'm going to give it a quick refresh, and if I need to enter in that last match, I can too. I think it's all entered in, so. All right, so now we are looking at our final score. Cordelia with a knife. Sitting at 4 wins, 0 losses, 20 points. So that means that Cordelia did not drop a single game this entire tournament.
Wow.
Very nice job, Cordelia.
Officially banned from Novice. We'll see you at Cordelia,
Excited to see you next week.
And well played to everyone. What an excellent tournament. Thank you so much, Polly, for being available to do some commentary with me. I'm so glad we got to take a look at our amazing new players. And thank you so much to Chaos for TOing our tournament today.
Absolutely, thank you. It is always a pleasure to join you on the microphone. And if you, again, if you haven't joined the Discord, if you're new to the community, we'd love to have you. So make sure to pop on in, click that link, and start swapping some panels.
All right, and now we are going to head over to the Puzzle Speedrun channel. They are, I think they're speedrunning Pokemon Puzzle League today, and I believe our very own BB Forky is doing some commentary. There's a lot of overlap between our communities. If you like Pokemon Puzzle League, Tetris Attack, definitely come check them out. Thanks everybody for being here. Bye, see you next time.
Bye. Thanks for joining us.